Hello everyone, in this video we will see summary of chapter 6, The Making of a Scientist, and it is written by Robert W. Peterson. In this video we will see summary in English and I will upload Hindi version of it soon, in which I will explain a detailed version of the chapter. So what is in this chapter? We will see character sketch first of all. So this story, The Making of a Scientist, is about a great scientist, Richard H. Bright. He had a habit of collecting butterflies, rock fossils, and coins. Since he was a kid, he started scientific research on study of butterflies. His curiosity and a will to win for the right reasons made him successful. So now we will see summary. Richard's success at young age. The article of Richard and his friend was published in the scientific journal Proceedings of the National Academy of Science. He was only 22 years old at that time. It was first time that the research work of college students was published. It was a rare honor for Richard. So Richard was become famous or become successful at a very young age. His paper was published in a scientific journal. So the meaning of paper is, if you write something or if you discovered have something, you write it in a paper and publish it in a magazine. So it is termed as a paper written by some scientist or someone. So at a very young age of 22, his research paper was published, and it was the first time when a research paper of a college student was published. So Richard, a collector from childhood. Now we will see how Richard was a collector of butterflies or things from his childhood itself. So Richard was only child of his parents. He grew up at Reading in Pennsylvania, USA. He had no one to play with. As he was only kid of his parents, he has no one to play with. So he started collecting things like rock fossils, coins, etc. Gazing at stars and collecting butterflies were his hobbies. So as he was the only child, he had no one to play with. So he started collecting coins, fossils. He used to gaze, means stare or look at the stars, and collected butterflies were his hobbies. Now Richard's mother, his companion means a friend, as he was no brother or sisters. His mother was his companion. Richard's mother was constantly with him. She encouraged him by taking him on trips and bought him telescope and other equipments. She found work to challenge him and helped him to learn a lot. So Richard's mother helped in his development of scientific temper a lot. Richard reads The Travel of Monarch 10. So reading of a child's book titled Travels of Monarch 10 inspired him. He became interested in the world of science. The book asked the readers to study butterfly migrations. Richard came in contact with a scientist to study butterfly migrations. Richard came in contact with the scientist, Dr. Urquhart, through this book, who influenced him greatly. Now, Richard raises monarch butterflies. So he started raising monarch butterflies. Richard decided to raise butterflies at home. So monarch is a form of butterfly. Richard decided to raise butterflies at home to study their migration pattern. He would catch a female monarch and take her eggs. He would He would watch all stages of development of butterfly. Then he would tag their wings and free them. He did it for many years and raised those butterflies, thousands of butterflies, in the basement of his home. So he started catching butterflies and started to tag them, to track their movement, and started to raise them in his house. So now Richard enters County Science Fair. Richard display his slides of frogs at the County Science Fair but did not win any award. He realized that he needed to carry out real experiments to win an award. He took suggestion from Dr. Urquhart, as a result of his many experiments, he won many prizes at the county and international science fairs in the following years. So he started his research and he won many awards. He won many awards in international science fairs. So Richard, 8th grade project. Richard tried to find the cause of a viral fever that kills thousands of monarch butterflies. He thought that a beetle may carry virus that causes viral fever. Although this was not the case, he still won the prize for his project. So again in the school, he won the prize for the study of viral fever in butterflies. Now Richard win at county science fair. So now he also won at county science fair. Now, Richard experimented on viceroy butterflies. He tried to prove that viceroys copy monarchs. So, monarch is a form of butterfly and viceroy is also a form of butterfly. Viceroys do it to protect themselves from birds, as birds don't eat monarchs. The project won the first prize in the zoology division and overall third prize in the county fair. So, he won third prize in the county fair overall and first in the zoology division. Now, Richard discovers a hormone. Richard was curious to know reasons behind 12 gold spots on the monarch pupa. Pupa is a child of the baby butterfly or a baby butterfly. So he started to reason why it has 12 gold spots on it. He and his friends built a device to prove that spots were producing hormone necessary for its full development. Project GOM got him first prize in county fair. He also entered International Science and Engineering Fair. He got third prize for zoology in this fair also. So in this part, he studied how hormones helps in the development of the butterfly. Now Richard continues his research on monarch pupa. So he continues his research on the butterfly, baby butterfly. Richard grew cells from the wings of a monarch butterfly. He further proved that cells grow into scales of wings only when they are injected with hormone from the gold spots. He carried on his work at the Army Laboratory and Laboratory of US Department of Agriculture. So he started doing research on many other places like US Department of Agriculture and others. After his freshman year at Harvard, he returned to the laboratory of the Department of Agriculture to identify chemical structure of hormone. This gave him new idea about cell life. So he started researches at so many places, and when he was researching, he got idea how hormone chemical structure. He started to identify the chemical structure of hormone of monarch pupa. Now, Richard's research on the hormone gave him an idea. He believed that his study could tell how cells read their DNA. He, along with his college roommate James R. Wong, worked on the idea. Then they wrote a paper explaining their theory. So he started working with his roommate and they prepared a paper on their theory about the DNA of the monarch butterfly. Now Richard graduated with second position in the class of 1510 students. He became graduate student researcher. He started experimenting to prove his new theory. His theory may create new ways to prevent some types of cancer and other diseases. Now Richard started to research further, and his researches, if were completed, may prevent cancer and so many other diseases. Richard was not just a scientist. He was an all-rounder. He was a good debater and a public speaker. He was also a photographer and an outdoors person. His social studies teacher praised him for his will to work hard, do his best and win. Richard had all qualities that made him a true scientist. He had curiosity and first-rate mind. He wanted to win for the right reasons. So this chapter, we have studies about the scientist Richard and how he discovers all the things that he discovered, how he worked, how hard he worked, and all those things. So thank you.